history classes. My name is Jesse Lynch. Most likely, if you're watching this video, you signed up for one of my history classes or my humanities through film class. And I want to welcome you. I want to welcome you to this class. I want to welcome you to this term, Fresh Start. And I just want to kick it off right to get to introduce myself, introduce our classes, and expectations of what to look at when you take history class or humanities through film class with me. I do structure, reason this video is to all my classes, because I try to structure my classes pretty much the same in every one of them. So the structure, underneath structure of the class tries to remain the same. The material will be different, of course, but if you've ever taken a bunch of different online classes from different instructors, the first thing you kind of realize is whatever is in their head of how they develop the class is different than another instructor. So you spend a lot of time trying to figure out what's expected of you, what's expected for the class, how to navigate the page for a Canvas page. And you just figure that out, and then the semester tends to end, and then you have a new instructor and you have to learn that all over again. So what I try to do with my classes is have the structure the same as much as possible. So if you return and take other classes from me, or if you're taking the same taking a couple different of my classes at the same time, you can kind of go in there, understand the format, understand what's expected, it's the same class, and then you can just focus on the material, focus on what you need to learn. This is your first time you've clicked into this class and trying to see what's going on. So I wanted to just give a quick sort of introduction of what to expect for any of my classes, what's the main sort of things that you're graded on, what things to expect every time you log in, that sort of thing. Class, when you log into Canvas, I try to do weekly videos at least of what's expected for that week. But really, you can figure it out yourself very easily. If you go to the modules page, that's kind of where I put everything that is needed for the week, for the whole term. So you have small group discussions. My classes are pretty large as far as numbers, as people in them. Some of them sometimes 60 people in a class. So if you were in a discussion forum and you had to read 60 people, that gets old. So you're put into small groups, normally about five. So five people that you will spend the whole term with in a small group. So you'll get to know those five people. I encourage you to really interact with them. You can meet with each other in that chat room on Canvas. You could use that as a study guide for each other. You could study with each other. I encourage collaboration. Exams can be stressful. We all know that. And if you take away the stress of that as much as you can, you tend to be better at it. The biggest thing, if you show up every day and if you do these discussions, you're going to rock the class, because then it'll make the quizzes easier and it'll make the exam easier. There's an exam. So your post will have to show somehow evidence that you've read, somehow evidence that you're using that and thinking about it critically. There's no real wrong answer to it. There's no black or white answer in history in general. The biggest thing I'm interested in is why. Why is it important to learn this? Why are we spending time out of our day to learn this information of the past? I think as a historian, the biggest crime to this subject is forcing students to memorize dates and to memorize names with no connotation of why. So you won't be expected to memorize a date. You won't have to memorize anything. Nothing is memorization. You can have open book in everything. The thing you have to do the most is think of why. Why is this important? What does this tie into some of the larger themes of the class? Themes like identity. Themes of why do we have stereotypes and how are those impactful, for good or bad? And how does history sort of break down or show, those identities of the past and how they affect us today? Every student in my classes comes from a different background, has different worldviews, has different beliefs, has different, lives in different places, right? So all that plays into how you see things, how you understand things, how you understand things politically, how you understand things socially, and how you look at the past that way. So that's what makes the discussion so rich, is because I'm going to have you in five different, a group of five. Each one of you has a different background, maybe different age, different beliefs and everything. And you're going to look at the same material differently. So it'll be so interesting to see your perspective. Some of you, it'll rub you the wrong way. Some of you will be like, I don't agree with this person every week at all. And think of it like this, that's not a bad thing, because that's life, isn't it? So how can you engage in a constructive respectful interaction with people that you don't agree with in the safe environment online. And that's what's going to be happening. So have fun with it. Be respectful. I read absolutely everything that's on here because I do incorporate that into your grade. But know that it's a safe place, okay? And if for any reason you feel it's not, you just let me know. So, I pride myself that my class is structured for you to succeed and wherever you go. So it's not just to succeed and get an A in this class. This is a transfer class, and I expect every single one of you capable of transferring to any university you wish. So if you succeed in this class, the skills is not just learning history, it's learning how to really thrive in a university environment as well. I myself went to Shasta Community College. I started there. I started in Redding, California in high school, went to West Valley, from there transferred to UCs, went to UC Santa Cruz, came back, went to Berkeley, San Francisco. I've taught at Simpson, I teach with you at Shasta, I teach here at a top university in the world at University of Exeter, worked with Oxford and Cambridge and all these places, and it started at Shasta. So, you know, you from there can go absolutely anywhere, and I am here to help, to equip whatever you need. Biggest thing is communication, okay? Whatever you feel are hoops and hurdles that are stopping you, communicate with me and we can work together to see how to get over those. Okay, that's a big part of my job. Teaching you history is a fun part, but really getting you to get to the next stage of your academic goals is what we're here for. So I'm excited to be a part of that with you. Okay. If this is your absolute first time in college, please send me an email and say hello, and you know, whatever concerns or anxieties you might have, let me know. There's great services with Shasta College. If you have any learning disabilities at all, any process with the information that's hard for you, closed captioning I'll be working on. Also financial things. EOPS is fantastic for first-time college students if you haven't been there. I know a lot of the services, I know a lot of people there. So if you're not plugged into these and you think you should be plugged into something, let me know and we can work with that as well. This is a history class or humanities through film class. I tend to try to have as much fun with these as possible. I'm a student as well. This is kind of a fun outlet for me to also connect with my Northern California people. If you're there, you might be all over the world as well, and that's awesome. But I try to have fun with this. And I know it's online and we're not there, but it's kind of, we're hanging out together one-on-one. That's the cool thing about an online class, okay? So again, welcome. Look forward to hearing to you all one-on-one, and I look forward to having another great semester with you all. So enjoy, welcome again, and I will talk to you very soon.